So in the pre-internet days, how did you communicate with your mom, right? Phone calls? At home. How did your mom tell you that someone needed to pick up milk?
Write a list, write a letter.
How did you plan a vacation?
You went to a travel agent. You got in your car.
You drove to the travel agent and you spent a few hours there. How did you do your taxes?
You went to H&R Block.
You took all of your W-2s and you went to H&R Block.
How did you order pizza? You called the pizza place.
How did you do your accounting?
You did it on a ledger.
How did you add a new server?
You bought one.
How did you research cars?
You drove to every dealer.
How did you entertain yourselves on the weekend?
Went to the video store.
These are all the things that we did in the pre-internet days.
In our personal lives.
What do we do today? How do we talk to our mom? We text, we Skype, we email, DM. How do we communicate that your mom needs you to pick up milk? Or needs someone to pick up milk? We do a family chat, right? Or the fridge tells us. How do you communicate with people? Email, Facebook, forums. How do you find your friends? Online. How do you book travel? Do you ever talk to somebody? Who does your taxes? Online. When you order a pizza? Online. You use QuickBooks? Online.
Blockchain.
Yeah, blockchain. When you buy a server, go to Vulture, go to AWS, spin one up in 5 minutes. How do you buy a car?
Research online.
I just put a deposit down on a that new electric pickup truck that was a Kickstarter. Comes out in 2020, and I never spoke to a single person. When I put the deposit down on my Tesla, same thing. Why is Tesla even in business? Because the major dealers no longer control all the information. How do we entertain ourselves? Netflix. YouTube. Okay, that's what the internet did for us in our personal lives, okay? There is a similar transformation that needs to take place within manufacturing facilities. This is the digital transformation of our personal lives. Our cell phones, my iPhone X here, is thousands of times more powerful than the computer that landed man on the moon. This is an extension of who I am. We are already cyborgs. I have all of human knowledge at my fingertips on this phone. So that was the digital transformation of our personal lives. So let's talk about how we used to do things. When you go to a website, how do you access the information on that website? Does the proprietor have to give you special access so that you can go to Airbnb and book a room in someone else's house and without ever talking to anyone? How do you access it?
Through the internet.
That's right, you just plug in.
You go into that namespace.
You just plug into the namespace, exactly, thank you. You go to airbnb.com. Is that a special domain, is it unique? If you go to airbnb.com, is there any chance you're gonna run into somebody else's information? No, you're not. And it's perfectly secure. You just go to the namespace, okay? What happens if you don't know where it is located in the namespace? What do?
Search.
You go to Google, you do a Google search. So that's really important. We do a Google search. Okay, let's talk about industry. In the pre-